That's right. We have Lito Adiwang from Team Leke. So trains up in Baguio, up in the mountains. Unlimited cardio, fantastic wrestling as well. And we also have Manuel Huerta, the Tick. He's training out of Phuket Top Team, and he's the assistant wrestling coach there, and he is also very good at wrestling. Let's see what happens here in this ring.
I wish we had a camera on us right now, because, I mean, Peter, I don't know if you just saw that, but Mitch right then was leaning forward, and he is glued to the action that's going on right now.
He doesn't want to commentate. He wants to watch this.
I'm just going to let you guys do the talking. I'm going to enjoy the show. Lito Adiwang is a very highly touted prospect out of Team Lakai. He is surrounded by how many world champions does Team Lakai have right now?
I can't count them.
He's got, you know, sparring partners like Joshua Pashiao, Kevin Bellingon, the current champion, Jehe Eustaquio, Edward Foleyang, Onario Benario, Edward Kelly. The list goes on
superstars.
And on. And Lito Adiwang is the next generation of Team Lakai fighters here at One Warrior Series. But he's got Manuel Huerta, who's trained a lot out of Alliance MMA. So his buddy, our current heavyweight champion, Brandon Vera, is probably glued to his screen right now, watching Manuel Huerta, the Tick, throw down.
But Lito Adiwang has some very, very good striking. That's going to be a big advantage for him against Manuel Huerta, because, you know, being a wrestling coach is one thing. You're definitely going to be training Muay Thai at Phuket Top Team, but having a fantastic base from a very young age in Sanda, or, you know, in Kung Fu generally, will allow you to do some crazy stuff with your kicks that you won't get in Muay Thai.
I'm wondering when we're going to see a takedown attempt from Huerta. He seems comfortable on his feet, changing the stances, going from southpaw to orthodox, light on his, quick with his movement, light on his feet.
He wants to. He's just a bit afraid of what leg's going to come from where.
Ooh.
I think that's the problem right now. And he did actually catch one of Lito's legs earlier, but Lito managed to brush it off. Okay. Not bad there. Manu Huerta getting in some kicks of his own. Some left low leg kicks, left high head kicks. Trying to get that takedown. Ankle grab there, ankle pick.
Both of these guys looking very, very composed, very, very focused.
They're still trying to gauge out their distance, I think. You know, Lito, I'm sure, has heavy hands, but he hasn't really thrown them too much yet. Actually, the Tick actually managed to land more hands earlier, like solid hands on Lito, than the other way around. I want to see more kicks from Lito. I really do. I'm excited to see Kung Fu.
Nice combination. Went to the body with the uppercut. Hurt it with the right hand.
He's panicked. He is really, really panicked. Lito's just going to carry on down this path.
Oh, look at him just beaming. Look at him just glowing almost as he's marching forward, throwing some serious heat with those hands.
Oh, my goodness. There you go. These are the Baguio Team Lakai hands that, you know, we're talking about. It's like Filipino boxing style. They love it. Mixing in with the Kung Fu, striking is really their thing, but it's going to be hard to take them down because their wrestling at Team Lakai is pretty amazing too. Oh, I would not want to be in there with Lito right now, but if Manuel Huerta can get his flow, the takedowns are going to come out strong. When he gets on the ground, who knows what will happen? We haven't seen it yet.
I do know that you're a Kung Fu practitioner, Peter Davis, but they've developed their own style of wushu. It's that Lakai style. Oh, beautiful front kick. Landed there. Check out that. Oh, my.
Lifted him.
Almost levitating him like he's David Blaine with a beautiful uppercut. Sends him onto the canvas and then just jumps all over him. The hype is real, Dominic Lau.
It sure is. I tell you what, man. I mean, just then, both of those gentlemen giving each other the respect that they deserve.
Winner. Go.
Adiwang, with a 7-2 mixed martial arts record, has a winning appearance in Rich Franklin's One Warrior Series already to his name. Da Silva is 2-1. Making his One Warrior Series debut.
Now, De Silva is a KO artist, so let's see what he does with Lito, who also likes to stand and bang. That guy is very, very dangerous, and, you know, training with the Team Lakai guys, it's expected.
Yeah, this is going to be a striking exhibition, I imagine. Doesn't look dissimilar to Kevin Belingon, does he, with that ponytail at the back? And he's got that ferocity, too.
That's right, a massive knockdown there with a big right hand.
Where he mixes punches and kicks, and we saw a ferocious attack. He just drove forward there, left and right, swinging in wide arcs. And when his opponent hit his back, he just jumped on him, finished the job. And it was the referee who eventually came in and called a halt to it.
Winner!
Former URCC champion. This one's going to be a good one.
Adiwang in the red trunks, red band around his wrists. Doe moving. He's kind of circling with his hands, changing stance, southpaw to orthodox and back again. Very light on his feet.
Bit of a feeling out process.
Yes.
Yeah.
Get the feeling that Adiwang is a little, well, he's up on his toes as well. Oh, right hand, left hand. Furious pace, the driving takedown attempt, single leg.
Doe's looking to lock his hands around the body here. He wants to go for a body lock, takedown. So look for him to try to get those hips across and go for a throw if he can get those hands locked. But Adiwang doing a great job knowing that that's what secures a takedown, and so he does not want to allow those hands to get locked. Great defense here. People don't realize how important that is, head position and wrist control in these types of situations.
Locked in the corner post. I suppose the difference between a ring and a circle there, when you're in the corner post, you're jammed in. It's difficult to drive your opponent one way or the other, Misha, isn't it?
Yes, huge hooks coming from Adiwang. He is very, he came out so calculated and calm and slow, and then the explosive power. But I mean, that's how you have to measure it, right? That's how he's going to keep his cardio if this does go deep into the third round, right? Is in this type situation now, he's getting that back right.
Oh, two big right hands. Doe goes down. He's back up on his feet, bounces up like a jack in a box. But those were big right hands from Adiwang.
Yeah, that's the thing that stands out the most from Adiwang. He's so explosive. Goes from 0 to 100 just like that.
Center.
He's got that big shock of hair at the back, a little bit like his teammate Kevin Belingon from Team Lakai.
And that right hand cocked right away. He's ready to fire that. Anthony, though, needs to tie him up, needs to slow him down over here right now, because Adiwang has landed some big shots that hurt him.
Anthony Doe has that leg, though. See, yeah, he's trying to get, or excuse me, the arm around his leg.
The arm's locked in between the legs there.
I think that Adiwang's already postured enough, though. He doesn't really have to worry too much about a submission in this particular.
Oh, he's coming down with the left and rights. From the upward position, there's a little head bump there. Nothing intentional, but that's just the ferocity of the situation. Both working hard. Not languishing at all. Final bout of the evening. It's going to be a question of cardio, then Adiwang you'd have to favour. Team Lakai absolutely renowned for that. Coach Mark is in the building, the head of Team Lakai. He's in good spirits before we got underway earlier today.
Doe seems to be okay here. Seems to recover from the hard strikes from Adiwang just now. He needs to look to tie him up again, because you know Adiwang is just conserving his energy for the next explosion.
There's that spinning, famous spinning kick you see utilized so well from Team Lakai.
Yeah. Flying knee was a little bit short. Got a little bit of smile there. Does look a bit like Kevin Belingon, doesn't he? Belingon's big strength is a seamless attack, switching from feet to hands without any.
You know, and what I really like about Adiwang's style so far, as you mentioned earlier, Gianni, about pace change. He's really good at changing the pace. He's lulling Doe to sleep a little bit, kind of just being so relaxed and calm on the outside. But then he changes the intensity so quickly, and that's very hard to time.
Very, very hard to time. But there you see Doe actually time the explosions of Adiwang. Sometimes it can work against you as well. If you swing a little bit too wild, it leaves you for openings.
Come
and Doe
keep working.
Has the back of Adiwang right now. Nothing secured yet, but oh, Adiwang with the Kimura of his own sweeps him over the top.
Great scrambles great by scramble. These guys. Adiwang locked up a submission of his own and used it to sweep through just when I thought Doe was going to get on the top with a big takedown.
Doe came in with a big overhand right there and looked to land the elbow as well, like a double whammy in one punch. And neither connected, but there was a big smile drawn from his opponent. Last few moments of this opening round, and it's been a ferocious pace. Adiwang really giving it absolutely everything with every punch.
Doe as well showcasing his experience, staying really calm, even though he's been under the barrage of strikes of Adiwang.
Final 10 seconds, opening round, last bout of the evening. Swinging back kick, we see that a lot, as Misha said, from the Lakai specialists. Bang. Let's take a look at some of the action from that first round, Gianni.
Uppercut, left hook, right cross, and then keeps the forward momentum. The right hand, that was the one that hurt him. And he kept the pressure up after that. Look at that. He just throws with everything, Lito.
Lito Adiwang, although he's anything but calm when he actually starts to mix it.
Yeah, Doe was able to time the explosion of Adiwang late in the first round and get into the clinch. Although he wasn't able to finish it. Let's see if he's able to time that a little bit more as this bout progresses.
So Anthony Doe has a completely different strategy in this. He's trying to stay as busy as possible to confuse Adiwang on when he should be explosive. When is the right time? I mean, it's really hard to tell that when you have somebody who just won't sit still in front of you, that's never planted. There's not really a perfect time to implement that type of explosive striking we've been seeing from Adiwang.
Right uppercut and left hand from Adiwang there. They were glancing blows. Certainly did not stop Doe in his tracks.
And much harder to hit a moving target. As you see Adiwang really committing, he's throwing where Doe is and not exactly where Doe is going.
Just constant movement, isn't it, from these two?
Non-stop, both are swinging heavily. That was a good body kick, doubling up there. So we see Adiwang's trying to change up his strategy a little bit, now going to the body, finding that opening there. That's a good adjustment. Yep. You know, the strikes were missing, strikes were missing from Adiwang, but the kicks, there was an opening there, now going down to the ground. See Doe timing that again, able to get inside.
Yeah, but every time Doe's been able to land a takedown, Adiwang has locked up that Kimura
yes.
position.
It's working.
You're absolutely right, Johnny.
To yeah. do that as you're on your way down to the canvas, take some quick thought.
Oh,
that could turn
now.
Into an armbar, though.
Great job by Doe. Does it have it locked up?
It is locked. This could definitely.
Oh, this could be tight.
He's got to drive
good.
In. Adiwang right here has to drive down and in.
Oh.
And really try to collapse the pressure there, and he's doing a great job so far. Now he's working to get that. That was incredible. That was very, very deep. I think almost anybody else may have been finished in that, but great
keep
way
working.
For Adiwang to keep his
Action.
Composure in a very dangerous situation. Did exactly what he needed to do to escape.
Yeah, doesn't really have time to think about being relieved, does he? Straight back into it.
Yeah, both men really making the adjustments mid-fight. Adiwang saw the movement of Doe, started going to the body, and then Doe as well looked to time the kicks and went under. That's how he got the takedown. But now they're both
position.
Back into the bottom position, scrambling, working hard again.
Doe working well with fist and forearm to get to Adiwang's head. With his
Doe.
Canvas.
Yep.
Now, what have we got?
Ooh, he's got a potential triangle locked up, but Adiwang rolls up the top. Both men just perpetually moving.
So hard to get that timing. Doe, that's the second time that he's reached underneath that leg there and used that to kind of create an angle. Now we find Adiwang capitalizing. He's got a potential triangle here if he can get those legs locked with the arm in there. He's trying to go for that, but Doe, being savvy on the ground as well, recognized that threat and was able to shut that down. Now he's in half guard. I think when either of these guys get on top, they need to focus on neutralizing the one on bottom. So now Do is on top. If he wants to get some offensive going, he's got to slow down the pace, be a little bit sticky, right? Because these scramble situations, oftentimes both these guys are ending up on the feet again, neutral, right? So I think maybe slowing down. But we have a potential guillotine. Adiwang, though, keeping his head high.
Oh, and now the blows come from way back.
Great ground and pound, very well executed to stand tall on that guillotine. Then he realized as soon as that was going to break, he was going to come down with the momentum and land that big right hand.
Just relentless, these two, Gianni. There's no stopping, is there? It's just constant movement.
They have not stopped in the last 10 minutes. Constantly moving, constantly moving. Both men. See, Do is looking for a sit-up sweep over there. But Adiwang over here is okay. Adiwang can actually pass to the left side because Do does not have his guard closed.
45 seconds left, second round, final bout of the evening. Rich Franklin's One Warrior Series live for you from Singapore. Misha Tate, Gianni Suba, Steve Dawson. Been great action today. Rich Franklin looking to award a contract, maybe even two. A ticket to the big time. And these two know that that is what's on the line.
Great job by Do extending the leg of Adiwang and using that with his underhook to get back up. But Adiwang showing that strength, showing that explosiveness, pulls him back down to the ground.
Looking to put that kind of crank pressure. Now he could turn that into a submission if he laces that bottom arm through, but that may be harder than it looks right here in this position.
Time.
Here's some of the action from that second round, Gianni.
Yep, there you go again. Doe's been able to get the back, but Adiwang threatens again with the Kimura. This was the armbar attempt by Doe as Adiwang looked for the Kimura again. Doe set up a really, really, really tight armbar, but Adiwang was able to pressure out. This was a really, really tight armbar. Like Misha said, many people would have tapped it with this armbar, but Adiwang showcasing the toughness that all these Baguio athletes show.
Last round, ready? Go!
The touch of gloves as we enter these final five. Like Balingon, when Adiwang kicks, he doesn't set himself. He doesn't take that little beat before he brings that leg up there. It just comes up.
Oh, these exchanges with the legs and the knees. These guys are getting really good timing for each other.
If anyone was questioning the cardio of both men, Lito Adiwang, the answer is here. This guy does not get tired.
No questions here, Gianni. Both moving very busily. Oh, right hand came in. Do was about to throw a left and it got pushed to one side. Bobbing, weaving, very busy from the waist and from the knees. Right hand, single right hand from Adiwang coming in between the guard, goes downstairs to the body.
Although there's still a lot of movement coming from Do, it has slowed down a little bit. He's planted a little bit more.
These blows will definitely slow him down. Good work with the hands and feet. Team Lakai style, that seamless switch between the two.
Do gets back on the clinch again. He's been able to drag him down with the body lock.
Oh, those knees to the midsection, those are brutal.
Oh. No, thought he had a guillotine there, but Do pulls guard to the guillotine. Does he have it? He has his hips on the wrong side. I don't think he has it here.
He's got to, yeah, get that right hip more down to the ground and really lean over the top of that guillotine. I think arm in guillotines are a bit more difficult to finish because you have the arm in there to kind of counter leverage. And when you have somebody as tough as Adiwang, it would be very difficult to finish an arm in guillotine, I would assume.
I agree. Very, very, very difficult to finish that against a very conditioned athlete.
Inside the final 3 minutes.
Stay inside. Stay in the ring.
Being told to stay in the ring by the referee. Shouldn't think that's foremost on their minds. Knees to the head. Damaging, damaging blows. Three of them. Follows it up with a left hand as well. Do does well to take those and come back with some punches of his own.
No back hit. No back hit.
Yeah, being warned about, oh, to the back of the head.
And as these guys are getting slippery, those submissions are going to be harder to catch.
They're just not holding, are they?
Yeah, those still hunting for submissions, but they're so slippery in this round, third round. Both men so sweaty, everything's just slipping out.
Yeah, they're nice setups. They're good. They're good catches. Just nothing's able to stick at this point.
Could well be all about the blows in the final 2 minutes of this contest then, with bodies slipping all over the place and grip so hard to engage.
Doe is doing such a good job of controlling that far side underhook. He's had that the majority of this bout. He finds a way. You'll probably see him try to swim this back under here if Adiwang tries to pass. And that's really what's not allowing Adiwang to control the position once he gets past the legs. He finds himself back in half guard or back in guard. Because there again, we see, Doe is recognizing if he's going to pass, I have to control this far side underhook, and that will allow him to get back into the position.
Inside the final 90 seconds. Looks as if the judges will be called upon. Difficult one, Gianni. How do you see it?
It's been very competitive so far, but I have to give it to Adiwang. He landed more significant strikes on the feet and on the bottom. Even though Doe is doing a lot of work from the bottom, Adiwang is pressuring forward. Just really showcasing, like Misha said, a full arsenal of MMA right now.
Is that how you see it, Misha?
Look, I think that this is very close. If I have to pick somebody right now, I think I agree with Johnny that it's going to be Adiwang. But again, I'm just glad I don't have to be a judge in this one, because I appreciate the offensive groundwork and submission from the bottom of Doe. You know, that great catch that he had with the armbar, that was so close. I mean, I really thought that may be the end of the bout. I really think only Adiwang could have survived that. So I think it's very close.
20 seconds left. Is there anything that either of these two men can do now to sway the judges' thinking?
I think the onslaught of Adiwang is going to be weighing heavy. I mean, look how he's finishing. He's finishing very strong, and that's another point. I mean, since we don't score round by round, a finish like this has to weigh heavy on the judges' scores.
Yeah, in the final round, Lito was able to find a home for a straight right hand. And he found success here in this half guard position, pulling on the head and landing some knees. He was just able to land more significant strikes throughout the bout.
Winner, right corner.
Jump! Well known as Team Lakai outfit with the blue tape around his wrists.
Lito Adiwang has looked impressive on his way here to the big show. He's going up against Senzo Ikeda, the former Pancras Flyweight World Championship. This is a step up for Lito Adiwang. Let's see how he does here.
Lito with that wide stance, arms and hands wide apart, light on the balls of his feet, on his toes there. And his opponent just faking him out, just pushing him towards the wall of the circle here. Exchange early kicks for the first time. 30 seconds into this contest. Right hand coming in from Ikeda. And that first interaction ends up against the circle wall.
Lito here's got his head up. Got a potential bulldog choke. He's got a stoppable position. Might have a submission here.
Right above us here at circle side. The referee's well positioned.
Ooh, that looks tight. He's got his hips in.
I'm watching very carefully. I can see Ikeda's face, the Japanese man in front of his home fans, desperately trying to get out of this one. Lito's doing all he can to make sure that hold is nice and tight, the anguish on his face, the effort he's putting in.
And Lito's here got a scarf of Kimura, he's cranking on the arms like an arm bar, using his hips just to drive forward. There's a lot of pressure on Ikeda's arm right now.
Ikeda just grabbing the circle with his toes there, he's released it now, but that's an illegal move, so he got away with that. And he's been circled away from the circle edge now.
That looks so tight by Ikeda, a veteran. He knows what's at stake here. He's not going to give up so easily.
Ikeda pops out now. 45 seconds or more was in that hole. It must be draining for both athletes.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Motohiro Suhura, has called a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 57 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of technical knockout, Lito Adiwang.
Finds himself here against the Thunder Kid, Lito Adiwang. Crowd inside the Mall of Age Arena behind the latest sensation from Team Lagarde. Outside leg kick from Pongsiri Mitsatit, the Muay Thai North Thailand champion. 72-17 Muay Thai record, 49 knockouts. Thunder Kid, a two-time regional Wushu champion, also a regional Muay Thai champion. BJJ Malaysia gold medalist in Johor. All blue belt BJJ Malaysia silver medalist. On a six-match winning streak. A high kick there from the Thunder Kid. And here comes the Thunder. Here comes the Lightning. Down goes Pongsiri Mitsatit. This place has gone bananas. The Thunder Kid. The Thunder Kid. Fourth hammer coming down on Pongsiri Mitsatit.
Survived. He was able to weather the storm, keep a nice tight guard as Lito Adiwang unloaded on Pongsiri Mitsatit.
What a start from Lito Adiwang. The Thunder Kid brought the thunder, brought the lightning, brought the hail. And down they go to one knee, now back up to a standing position. Adiwang with a takedown, nicely done, goes to side control.
Oh, beautiful redirect, puts Pongsiri Mitsatit on his back, but he's got that underhook on that side. Now, Lito Adiwang's going for that scarf hold, key lock. You can see him trying to shove that arm into his legs. Looks like it might be a kimura right there, I can see it.
Is he going to make it seven wins in a row? The Thunder Kid, and no, says Pongsiri Mitsatit, takes the back standing of the Filipino.
Wow, what grit coming out of Pongsiri Mitsatit as he was able to survive two extremely bad positions. And now he's got the back of Lito Adiwang. Lito Adiwang's going to try to separate those hands and spin and go chest to chest.
The aggressor meter off the charts for Lito Adiwang at the start of this contest. Not even halfway through the first round.
Yeah, looks like he's trying to attempt a kimura lock there on the hands as he tried to roll through. Good job by Piak to hold that body lock nice and tight and maintain positioning. You can see that Lito Adiwang, I don't know if you can see, but he's got a kimura grip on that arm right there, and he's gonna try to use it to sweep and reposition.
Adiwang has not lost a match since 2014. A 90% finishing rate, you can see why, including a massive amount of first round finishers. He's had five in his last six bouts. Have been first round finishers. He's looking for another one here.
He's still going.
He's done it! He's done it! He's done it! It's goodnight, Irene!
Look at that. Takes it up over the head. Beautifully done. I think he learned that from Joshua Pashiao from the passion lock. Almost the same. Another beautiful submission win from Team Lakai. Look at this. He steps over the head, locks it into position, starts cranking on the arm.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kemp Cheng, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 2 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of kimura, Lito Adiwang.
Competing to improve his ranking, he's currently number five, but competing for a lot more too, Drac.
Yeah, he spoke to me earlier this week and he said that his mom had a stroke and she's going through kidney problems. He's the youngest of seven children, so this match means the world to him. He really wants to bring back that one championship medal to his family and his mom.
There's a reason they call Adiwang the Thunder Kid. Will we see it here in the first round? Will he bring the thunder? It's happened every afternoon this week in Singapore, as it usually does. Will it happen in Singapore tonight, courtesy of Thunder Kid Lito Adiwang? That action. Right hand cocked and ready for destruction, and he throws it early. Double leg takedown attempt here from the latest Shooto champion, debuting one. Hit on Minowa, gets the takedown inside the guard of Lito.
Adiwang touched Minowa on the chin with that right hand, and Minowa thought differently right away. Shot him for a beautiful double leg takedown. Spins around, puts Adiwang on his back. This is where Minowa excels, ladies and gentlemen. He is a monster on the ground. Once he gets people down, he just slowly starts advancing his position, softening up ground and pound. He's really got to try to drain that gas tank of Adiwang, because Adiwang is so explosive, not just on the feet, on his escapes as well.
Both men bringing in tremendous records, going 8-2 in their last 10. 100% finishing rate on Minowa. Can he take care of business? Can he pass the side control here? Or at least go to half guard against Lito, who's keeping him locked in the full guard at the moment.
Adiwang's got him in full guard, but he's also attacking a Kimura on the left side of Minowa. You can see he's got that arm now, and all he's got to do is he's got to try to separate the hand away from the body and create a little bit more torque on that shoulder.
Adiwang does have 36% submissions, 55% knockouts, and he wins so far. Very aggressive start as always from Lito. Going to town on that left arm.
Oh, beautiful. Through the leg, over the back of the neck there of Minowa. Now he can probably use this as a sweep. See how Minowa's rolling over? So Lito Adiwang was able to use that Kimura to reverse the position. And now he's in a domino. He's rolling through.
Is Minowa in trouble here, Dragon?
Yeah, Minowa's in a world of trouble right now. He's got that arm extended. Now it's starting to separate from the body. See how that arm is twerking like that? Oh, the arm is not supposed to bend that way, but Minowa is so tough.
It looks painful. My word, the resilience here from Minowa. Did he tap out? No. And still Lito goes to work on that left arm. How is Hiroba Minowa surviving this? As Mitch said, the arm going in the direction that human arms should not go.
Man, anybody else would have tapped long ago. But Minowa is a monster. I told you, ladies and gentlemen, he is not going to give up in his debut. He really wants that number 5 spot from Adiwang, and he is willing to do whatever it takes to get it.
Hiroba Minowa survives the early onslaught from Lito Adiwang. Top position still here for the Japanese combatant. Lito has to reset now. Side control, north-south position. Nice bit of the clavicle there from Hiroba. Looks to go to side control again. Gets there, the Japanese athlete. Cup the hips in. Knee on belly momentarily from Hiroba. Nice done. Minowa doing a great job so far. Inside a half guard. In control after a very precarious situation about a minute ago where Lito almost took the arm back to Baguio City.
Yeah, Lito Adiwang almost got back-to-back Kimura submissions. He scored a huge Kimura submission back at Fire and Fury against Pongsiri Mitsatit. He was trying to go back-to-back with the Kimura, but Minowa is so tough, ladies and gentlemen. He must be hypermobile in those shoulders, which is a huge benefit for grapplers because that arm back was deep. Look at that good movement from Adiwang to get back into half guard. Now he's got to try to get under hooks and shift over onto his side and create that movement.
Nice posture up there from Minowa. Drops the left hand down. 20 seconds remains. First round of 3. What an electrifying start to this one championship card coming at you from the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Half guard position, Hiroba Minowa back into full guard now. Lito closes the guard. The Filipino throws the legs up, hoping to secure an armbar just before the bell. Can he find it? No. What a ripper. What a start from Lito Adiwang.
Man, Adiwang has improved his ground game, ladies and gentlemen. Look at that. Boom with the 2. Follows with the 3. Throws the 2 again, and Minowa shoots immediately in for that single leg. And this is where the ground battle started to happen. Look at how deep this Kimura is, ladies and gentlemen. That is a nasty looking Kimura, and Minowa just rolls right through it.
Mitch, nasty is an understatement. When the Kimura is locked on, what are you trying to do with it to your opponent?
You're trying to take that arm home. He wanted to bring it back to Baguio City, but you could just see that it's a shoulder lock, and the arm is being twisted away from the body, and it just creates tremendous torque on the shoulder joint. But Minowa hung in there like a champ.
Second round set for three. Strawweight contest. 21-year-old Hiroba Minowa against 27-year-old number five ranked Lito Adiwang. Don't forget, folks, follow us across all your social media platforms at One Championship on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and Instagram. And as always, we thank the Singapore government for making tonight possible, keeping us all very safe and happy and healthy. What a start from Lito in the first half of the first round. Almost getting the win via Kimura. Tremendous resilience, though, from Hiroba Minowa. And he's up high on the balls of his feet early, the Japanese Shooto champion. Fake there from Lito, controlling center circle. Turning back kick, the jump to his back kick. They love that at Team Lakai. We've seen it used by Kevin Bellignon to great effect. Maybe Bellignon can get it off our main event tonight against Hands of Stone, John Lineker. On the ground once more inside the first minute of the second round. In the guard of Lito is Hiroba Minowa.
Improve your position.
Good takedown there landed by Minowa. Beautiful timing on his entries into these shots. He was able to catch Adiwang kind of coming forward and committing into that spinning back kick, and he just closed the distance and got nice and tight. If Adiwang wants to sort of avoid these takedown attempts, he's gonna have to have more balance. He's gonna have to be a little bit more centered in his approach, throw those hands, hurt him with leg kicks, but earn that respect, because Adiwang does his best work on his feet. Even though his ground game has improved by leaps and bounds, as we saw in that first 5 minutes. And now we're seeing Adiwang able to control, but beautiful pass. Throws the legs to the side, follows it up with a right hand landed by Minowa.
Minowa, 100% finishing rate, 27% by knockout, 73% by submission. Never won by decision. What's he looking for here, Dragon?
Check out the right arm of Minowa. Minowa has grabbed the right arm of Adiwang. So that's going to open up a little bit more options in his part. He's going to be able to, if he can slide that leg through, he's going to be able to secure that hand. And Adiwang's not going to be able to defend himself as well, because Adiwang looks like he's possibly going for a Kimura on that other side as well. Intricate little chess game going on right here between two high-level athletes.
Adiwang told us he knows how skilled Minowa is on the ground. Was going to try and finish him in the stand-up. Didn't believe that Minowa could finish him in striking. And in fact, Lito has never been stopped by strikes through 12 pro bouts. Also holds a 15-2 amateur boxing record, does the Thunder Kid, but no chance to rain down the thunder on Hiroba Minowa at the moment. And just a tangle here. What is Lito going for now, Mitch?
He's going right back to the Kimura. He loves this submission. It just gives him so many more opportunities. He can sweep with it, but a beautiful job by Minowa to kind of maintain that composure. Oh, beautiful little slip out to the side there by the hip switch by Lito Adiwang. Now he's dropping the hammers down, but good job by Minowa to regain that composure. You mentioned Adiwang's record and how good he's been doing lately, but it's the last seven matches. There has been a switch thrown in Lito Adiwang, and he has just found another level. And I really think it has to do with his training partners. He has joined Team Lakai, and he has surrounded himself by some of the very best athletes in all of the Philippines, pretty much all of the world. And we're really starting to see that in his game. And his ground game has improved as well. But right now, this is Minowa's world. This is what Minowa loves to do. Let's just smother his opponents. But you can just see how active Lito Adiwang is. He keeps trying to negate the position of Minowa and keep things moving. 1 minute
left in the second round. It's been a long time since I commentated the name Minowa. He used to be associated with a very famous pair of red underpants, Dragon.
Yeah, now the red shorts are on the other team now. Look at the good control by Minowa. He's able to secure that half guard. You can see how he's got that body lock tight to the guard. It's that underhook on his left side, how he has that arm of Lito Adiwang. That's given him really good control, and it's enabling Minowa to keep Adiwang flat to the mat. If you're inside control, you have to try to scoot your hips away from your opponent so you can create that space. But when you can't and you're stayed flat to the back, you're just kind of stuck in that position.
Adiwang's got to create that movement. He's got to keep moving, because here you can see now Nil was in north-south, and he can drop those knees to the head.
And dropping them, he is indeed. The cranium crackers there off the right knee from Hiroba Minowa, a 21-year-old who has never been finished, has a very impressive second round.
Good ground control by Minowa. He was just able to shut down the offense of Lito Adiwang. You could see in the first match when Lito Adiwang was in guard, when he had his both legs wrapped around Minowa, he was able to attack submissions. He was able to go after that kimura. He was able to go after the armbar. But then once Minowa started to advance his position and showcase that ground control, we could see that he could shut down the offensive attack of Lito Adiwang.
So the end swell being used to the side of the left eye and on the forehead of Minowa. Mitch, we score as an overall contest under the global rule set, but if you were scoring this one round by round, who would you have ahead at the moment?
It's pretty close. I think the submission attempt and just how deep that kimura was in the first round by Lito Adiwang gave him the advantage in that round. And I think that, you know, Minowa was able to sort of get a lot of that back, you know, make up a lot of ground with his just ground control in that second. But I think it's really close at this point, and it could go either way. And I think it's going to depend on Adiwang keeping it on the feet and Minowa getting it back down to the ground.
Third and final round, Hiroba Minowa, 7 of 8 submissions via choke, 6 via rear naked choke. If he takes the back of Lito, it is danger for the Thunder Kid. No sign of that yet. It's been Lito, the Filipino, who has had the submission opportunities. And again, you see the Thunder Kid controlling center circle, pressing Hiroba Minowa to the outside. Plenty of movement, both drifting right and left for Hiroba Minowa.
See, Michael, you can see that, you know, Minowa doesn't want to step into the range. He doesn't want to get close to Adiwang because he's, you know, nervous about those hands. But Adiwang's also a little tentative to throw the strikes because he doesn't want that double leg to shoot in on him again.
Adiwang protecting that number 5 ranking in the heated strawweight division. A loss tonight to Minowa. Could see Minowa slip into number 5. And what a stacked division it is.
Beautiful double leg again thrown down by Minowa. He was able to duck under that right hook. You could see that just the tentativeness of Adiwang into throwing that hook. And as soon as he threw that one strike, Minowa snuck right in there, turned the corner, put Adiwang down. And now we're getting to see what makes Minowa just so good.
Half guard position here for Hiroba Minowa. Looks to pass, does so. Wanted to take the back momentarily. Back inside of half guard. The champion in the strawweight division, the teammate of Lito Adiwang, Joshua Pascio. Number 1 ranked. Fellow Japanese man, Yosuke Saruta. Another Japanese number 2, Yoshitaka Naito. Rene Catalan, another Filipino number 3. The Brazilian Alex Silver at 4. And the Thunder Kid rounds out the top 5.
Yeah, the Japanese and Filipino martial artists are just dominating the strawweight rankings right now. And this is what we're seeing. We're seeing 2 very high-level strategic masters going at it right now. And this is the game plan of Minowa. We said at the very beginning, the ground was his world. And we're seeing why that is. Adiwang's got to get that underhook so he can turn onto his side to create that little bit of space. But Minowa knows exactly how just to, he's trying with the dig to that right hand. He's trying, but a beautiful adjustment by Minowa not to let him get that escape. He allowed Lito Adiwang to get back into full guard just to keep that position, because I think he knows just how explosive Adiwang is, and he might have been able to get out if he got that underhook.
Mitch, Adiwang has had 8 first round finishes, 3 by sub, 5 by knockout or TKO. When it goes beyond the first round, do you sense any confidence slipping away from the Thunder Kid if he can't get them out in the first 5 minutes?
You know, it's a very good point, Michael. You know, but I just don't get a lack of confidence ever from anybody from Team Lakai. They believe they are in the match from the start to the finish, and they can end you with just 1 well-placed shot. You can sleep, you know, and Lito Adiwang still has time to work through this. He's got to do what he's got to do. He's got to push off. But again, Min was just all over him. It's like being caught in a fishing net in the ocean. There's just no escape. No matter how much you struggle, you can't get away. You've got to rip through that fishing net and try to get to safety. But we're seeing a beautiful just control and top position game from Minowa.
Of course, two of the teammates of Lito on tonight's card in our co-main and main event. In the co-main, Jay Hayastakwio, former world champion, takes on Songmin Jong of Korea. And the big one, former world champion Kevin Bellignon, goes up against Hands of Stone, John Lineker, in a bantamweight stout. Inside the guard of the Thunder Kid, with 1 minute remaining, some Hanifus strikes posturing up momentarily from Hiroba Minowa.
Yeah, Minowa is only 21 years old. This guy has absolutely no ceiling here at one championship, especially putting on performances like this. But I also think this is going to do a good job just to Lito Adiwan's experience level. He's going to know what he needs to work on, and he's going to try to make those corrections by going back into the laboratory out there in Baguio and really putting in good work with Team Lakai. But we're seeing Minowa just put on a performance right now of ground control, ground and pound, and really just controlling this matchup.
Minowa looking to continue a streak and make it five in a row. For the Thunder Kid, it would be seven in a row if he wins this one. It is going to go down to the wire, you feel, unless a stoppage here from the hammer fist strike to be the man. Big hammer fist off the right hand here from Minowa. They are bringing it home strongly. Aggression from the bottom position from the Thunder Kid. And who will take the mod? Look at the sportsmanship, the respect and the honor between two phenomenal martial artists.
Wow, what a matchup between two top-level strawweights. Here is Minowa just letting go of the ground and pound at the very end of the round. I think we have a new contender in the strawweight division.
This match is presented to you by Xbox. Power your dreams. After three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this contest in favor of the red corner. Judge number two calls this contest in favor of the blue corner. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision from the red corner, Hiroba Minowa.
Kawahara has stopped his opponent in the first two rounds in six of his seven wins. Neither man used to going to deep water. Very wide stance here on Kawahara. Let's see if Adewang can flurry early. Small but excited crowd as one championship kicks off the 2021 calendar with a stacked card. Leg kick from Kawahara, counter overhand right fell short from Lito Adiwang.
Adiwang's going to try to bait Kawahara to come forward and get caught with some of these punches. I like how he's utilizing the leg kicks early because he also knows that Kawahara has really good movement.
Lito Adiwang in the traditional Team Lakai red trunks. Also has become tradition, the Team Lakai mullet. Leg kicks again from Lito Adiwang. The Thunder Kid raining down a storm so far on the legs of Kawahara. That very wide stance may be affecting the ability of Kawahara to check those leg kicks. Moves in for a takedown to no avail though. Right hand lead, stiff jab there from the Thunder Kid.
Kawahara did get deep into that takedown, but beautiful defense by Adiwang to stop him right in his tracks.
Kawahara the more flat-footed of the two, assuming that karate stance. Switching stance to southpaw, now back to orthodox Kawahara. Adiwang setting himself. Left hook to overhand right, loaded up the overhand right, but telegraphed it. Drift back to center circle. Nice outside thigh kick to the back leg there from Kawahara. The Thunder Kid clips him over the top. Overhand right coming very close for Lito. Kawahara showed his cards then with the right hand. Outside leg kick from the Japanese warrior.
Both these guys are winging the hooks at each other. They are letting those hands fly.
Absolutely no feeling out process in the opening round. Both men guaranteeing a knockout. Hands low on both. Adiwang's got the right cocked and ready. Adiwang has had success so far going to the legs of Kawahara. There's a kick to the ribs from the Thunder Kid. Kawahara now up on the balls of his feet, bouncing in and out, trying to find range. Adiwang still targeting the legs of Kawahara. What's the game plan there for the Thunder Kid Dragon?
And he knows exactly what Kawahara wants to do. He wants to come in and come out. He wants to bob in like a fencer and then get back out. If Adiwang can just start beating up those legs, it's really going to limit that movement, and it's going to slow Kawahara down, and he's going to be more stationary to get caught with some of these punches.
An overwhelming 83% of fans on the One Super app tipping a win for Lito Adiwang tonight. Adiwang went for the outside lead thigh of Kawahara. Kawahara tries to clip him with that looping right. No success so far with the hands of Kawahara. Adiwang thought about the front kick off the rear leg. A very calculated approach by Adiwang tonight so far. That was almost a hammer fist strike there off the left hand from Kawahara. A little unorthodox. Looping left hand from Adiwang. Good snappy jab and out of range immediately. Kawahara avoiding the counter strike. Adiwang has that beautiful ability to combine power with speed and precision.
Yeah, his speed almost creates that power, especially when he gets you hurt. He jumps all over you. You can see what these guys are trying to do. They're trying to pull each one of them, their opponents, into their punches. They're trying to move back and then counter with a beautiful cross.
Good outside leg kick there. Just connecting with the bottom part of the shin was Kawahara. Adiwang goes to the ribs, 3-2 combination. Another rib kick there from the Thunder Kid.
30 seconds left in the first round.
Good superior striking there from Lito Adiwang.
The biggest difference is these kicks coming from Adiwang. They are scoring in rapid succession, especially when Kawahara switches to southpaw. You can see Adiwang starts teeing off on that roundhouse kick.
Jab too, but the distance isn't there for Kawahara. Tries a jump turning back kick. Ucherogeri doesn't work for him. Good right hand lead there from Kawahara, trying to mix it up. Overhand right from Adiwang for the headache maker. Into the first round, we go to the towels. Folks, give us a follow across all your social media platforms at One Championship on Facebook and Twitter. Dragon, your thoughts after one?
Yeah, I like what the work that Adiwang did early in that round with those leg kicks and the body kicks as the round progressed. He was scoring very heavily, and he also slowed down that movement. As the round wore on, Kawahara seemed to slow down a little bit. He wasn't fully committing to those shots. He attempted a takedown early in that first. But Rich Franklin, how'd you break down the first five?
Yeah, I'll tell you, I scored him on that takedown defense there, but it was all about the striking in this round. And I've edged Lito out on this one, and I'll tell you what was the difference maker for me. With just a little over 2 minutes left in that round, Lito landed a nice kick right-hand combination that kind of threw Kawahara back a little bit. But otherwise, this is a pretty even chess match. I still have Lito inching it out after 5 minutes of action.
Right. Ready? Ready?
Great to have the ace, Rich Franklin, with us here in the Singapore Indoor Stadium tonight for One Championship Unbreakable. And as you saw after the first 5 minutes, the striking superiority in particular leaning the way of the Thunder Kid from the Philippines, Lito Adiwang. Skip up inside thigh kick, high to that femoral profunda there from Kawahara. Trying to throw a cannonball off that right hand did Adiwang. A little more coming forward already in this round from Kawahara. Adiwang circling into the right hand. The preferred hand of Kawahara, though he does switch stance a lot, as you are seeing. Good cracking rib kick. He's landed that a few times in the match so far, Adiwang. It's the power kick off the back leg. The torque of the hips, the pivots on the balls of the lead foot, enabling that beautiful Mawashigeti roundhouse kick. Adiwang leads in, swings the left hook.
Kawahara, very straight up stance, hands are low. Thinks he's a little quicker than Adiwang. Believes he can time it if Adiwang comes looping with the left or the overhand right, that he's got the quickness to evade it and get out of dodge.
He's having a hard time with the distance of Adiwang, though. If he closes the distance, he gets met with a flurry of punches. But if he stays at this kicking range, Adiwang's just a little bit faster with these kicks, and he's scoring with the legs.
Kawahara wears that leg kick to the back of the calf. Nicely placed from Adiwang. Kawahara needs to start committing to some techniques here. And you see Adiwang just playing mind games.
You mentioned the wide stance in the beginning of the first round, and it's kind of lending to the ability for Adiwang to land these leg kicks.
A wide stance is not conducive to checking low kicks.
It's hard to get that leg up and at least reduce some of the pressure that he's feeling from these leg kicks. He's got to start.
Oh, smack bang! Smack bang! Smack bang! Smack bang! One punch and the Thunder Kid is back! That was Thor's hammer in the left hand! The Thunder Kid is back!
He had a hard time with the range, and when he enters the pocket of Adiwang, he gets put down! What a beautiful left hand! Rich Franklin, I can see the excitement in your eyes. You're dying to say something.
I'm trying to be unbiased here because I have both athletes in the ring, but it's difficult to be unbiased when Lito is the one that came
from
my
roster. Can I just say, folks, right now, Rich Franklin has tears of joy in his eyes at this. Lito Adiwang, from the heartbreak at the end of 2020 to come back in the winner's circle tonight with a highlight reel one-punch knockout of Kawahara. That was startling. That is why they call him the Thunder Kid.
Oh, that was beautiful. Man, he packed some thunder in that left hook. What a thing of beauty.
This match was presented to you by Petron. Ladies and gentlemen, your referee has called a stop to this contest for your winner by way of knockout, Lito Adiwang.